All right, so we have our cell components quiz on the schedule today. You guys had some practice in, the Kahoot yesterday. How's everybody doing? You guys ready for your quiz? Because I'm not sure that Kahoot said you were ready for your quiz. Give me some chat. Scale of 1 to 5, how ready are you for your quiz? A lot of threes, even though you guys got 91s. I don't want you to take it like a 3 is a C. I don't want you guys to take a quiz if we're gonna get a C. But that's what I was seeing on the Kahoot. It did not look like we were prepared for a quiz. So how about we do this? How about we postpone it till Monday? Okay. Were there any of the things on the Kahoot that you could think of that you wanted to ask me questions about? While I am doing this, will you guys open up? Let's go back to our agenda while I find this. Open up, we have a warm-up like we did before, the hemostasis worksheet. We did this with hematopoiesis. It's a talk to the text kind of thing. So if you can add highlights, that's great. This gets turned in. This is our participation points of the day. Read through that. This is another tough topic. And then answer the questions that follow. I'm going to put us in breakout rooms so you can have conversations about it. Meanwhile, I'm going to find the Quizlet for you guys. So how many do we have today? 21. I'm going to do 5 groups. I was flipping through my like actual binder here. I have answer keys for every one of these already made, but this one. So darn it. But anyways, we'll go through this. So I noticed as I was flipping through, more people are highlighting on here. Be sure you read all of these pieces along the way on the picture, because like some of the answers were given in the small print. So 2 roles of the blood clotting system to prevent further loss and as a mechanical barrier to keep foreign organisms from invading our bodies. So the role of each of these, the injury exposes the collagen factors or the fibrin, and that's going to start the whole thing happening. Platelets stick to the collagen. I could practically not do the lecture now. It's all right here. The release of the chemicals from the platelets, serotonin, thromboxane, those are the chemicals. They are going to, actually this, I would say, now I'd have to go back and read this. I would think it would be to attract other, the surrounding platelets sticky. Okay, good job. They also will attract other platelets to the area. Clumping of platelets at the wound site makes a plug. So that's kind of like putting a plug in your sink so that water doesn't keep going down the drain. It'll prevent further blood loss, and the formation of the fibrin clot will trap the blood, reinforces the seal, and as the clot dries, it would form a scab. The role of the clotting factors, they catalyze. Remember, that's like to speed up chemical reactions, make it more likely for them to occur. Catalyze the change of plasma proteins, prothrombin into thrombin, thrombin into fibrinogen, fibrinogen into fibrin. So they change the plasma proteins to activate them, and then explain why these clotting factors are not normally present. Well, gosh, that wouldn't that be bad if blood was clotting inside your veins all the time? Blood would not flow very well. So they cause coagulation in the blood, which in large amounts would cause undesirable clotting. Good. And then they inherited diseases. When I think clotting factor, I think hemophilia in particular. Thrombocytopenia is a low count of thrombocytes, so a low level. Anytime you see penia, you can have, I had erythrocytopenia one time where I had low red blood cells. And you might have leukocytopenia, low white blood cells. So that penia is referring to low levels. Name the clotting factor involved. So that's where reading the little print here, we got thromboplastin and factor 8 were the 2 chemicals. So that worksheet is done. Hopefully you guys are starting to chat with each other in the boxes. When you're done with homework and you have spare time, like hopefully you guys visit with each other a little bit. So get some social going on. Okay. So that is our, can I pause the record or am I on record? I can always do it next hour. Okay, good. So I did find my Quizlet. We'll bring that up at the end if you want some extra practice for the quiz that we now will have on Monday instead. We'll stick around and you can do a Quizlet live with me at the end of the class if you want. So we're going to do the hemostasis, common mistake, lecture. Opened up another set of slides. So copy paste these slides onto your slide set. I kind of like the whole notebook being together. When you turn these in, is it better to resubmit? Do you think some of you resubmitted it and some of you added it as an assignment? Pretty easy to just like upload it to the attached assignment. But I was looking in two different places, so that got kind of confusing. But I want to show you something you need to do when you copy these. So last we were on slide 12. So we're going to copy slide 13 through 18. So again, control, shift, edit, copy, right click, copy, any of those things. And then you're going to open up your own PowerPoint. Now pay attention before you click your button here. So if this is my old PowerPoint, I'm going to control V, edit, paste, control, paste, whatever. It should, it didn't give me though. Usually it gives you a question like keep old formatting or keep new formatting. And if it does, you want to keep original format, not match format. Some of us did the match format on the last set and we lost a couple of slides because of it, but it must be I didn't reuse any of those slides, so we're okay. So these are our six slides that we'll work through. This one has a little bit of labeling. Some of us maybe didn't see the squares on the labeling, so I tried to make that more obvious. This is a simple question. These are questions. And then these letters will move. So you can move these onto the paragraph to the side. So that's kind of, instead of the quiz yourself at the end, we'll have those. Okay, so we should be ready to go. Anybody need more time finding their slides, adding their slides?
What are the keys that I press again? Control, shift.
For me, it's control. I'm gonna select more than one slide at a time. I select like number one and I'm gonna hit control shift and I select whatever one I want to go to, and it should select them all.
Okay.
I know Max, maybe they have three different options, control, Apple key, something else key, but on a standard computer keyboard, control shift allows you to select many things. If you wanted to select like 10 pictures at the same time, control shift. If I wanted to select 5 files to attach, control shift, that's made do many things at once. Anybody need more time finding the slides to add to their notebook?
Miss Snook, can you help me do it? I can't figure it out.
Sure. Let me just grab this. I am going to, so I selected 13 and I hit control and shift and I scrolled down to 18. Oops. I didn't mean to like minimize, control shift. And then I control C for copy. You can also go up here and do edit copy, or you can right click and select. So slide 12 was attached twice. Okay. This is where we left off. So I'm going to control V or edit, paste, or right click and paste. And I'm going to get rid of all these extra slides that I put on thinking I was being helpful. Who else was in here today? I don't remember. All right. Do you have them on there now, Cassidy?
Yeah, I have all to 15. That's what we need, right?
We're up to 18 now.
Okay, 1 second.
Your notebook up. I needed to shift over. Okay. Reading guide on this, 301 to 303. We only have one reading guide left, 305 to 8, I think, over the weekend. Many of you are already done. So this is the what's the point? What's the whole purpose of blood clotting? And then I'll have a slide that goes with that as well.
Usually, every time you have a cut or bruise, your blood clots to stop the bleeding. Clotting is a complex process, and there are four main things that make it possible. Platelets, or cell fragments, clotting factors, which are special proteins, fibrin, which is a protein mesh made up of a special kind of clotting factor, and finally, other cells, like red and white blood cells. Because clot formation is so important, platelets and clotting factors are always available, floating around in your blood. Now, let's talk about the four steps involved with forming a blood clot. When there is a tear in a blood vessel, the first thing that happens is that the nearby platelets are activated and become sticky. They start sticking to each other and to the sides of the hole in the blood vessel. For small holes, enough platelets usually stick together to form a temporary plug. But a platelet plug isn't strong enough to block the opening for long, so it must be reinforced with other materials. Otherwise, the blood flowing past the hole could wash the plug away. These other materials are called clotting factors. As the clotting factors float by the tear, they become activated or turned on and add themselves to the platelet plug. A special kind of clotting factor can weave itself together with others of the same kind and form a web of fibrous tissue, called fibrin. This web acts like glue and holds the platelets and the other clotting factors together, creating a blood clot. Other cells, like red and white blood cells, can also get caught in this web and help reinforce the clot. It quickly becomes stronger and starts to pull the edges of the hole in the blood vessel together. After the clot has formed, it stays in the hole until the tissue is repaired. When the clot is no longer needed, your body dissolves it.
Okay, so that's a good overview of the entire process. So I like that video a lot. Okay, so hemostasis. We're big on words here, understanding the Greek or Latin origination. Hemi is referring to blood, any word, hematopoiesis, hemostasis, hemoglobin, anything with hemi is going to refer to blood. Stasis is standing still or stopping. So it's literally the standing still of blood. SIS endings, like I said, are usually processes. So now we get the process of. So normally blood flows smoothly along the endothelium. That's referring to the inner lining of the blood vessels, capillaries, veins, arteries. When there's a damage to the vessel, as you read in your warm-up, the collagen is exposed. So collagen is a protein, and proteins are typically sticky in nature. So the sticking of the platelets to this collagen initiates the whole process of hemostasis. And this is referred to as a cascade because it's a chain of events where one thing leads into the other. So this is your capillary, right? So this is the endothelium. This is the inner layer. This would be an epithelium, the outer layer. So the endothelium, when it's cut, fibrin is exposed. And platelets, because fibrin is a sticky protein, fibrin will get stuck to it. Platelets will get stuck to it. And when they get stuck to it, they start to release chemicals, thromboxane, ADP, and this is going to attract other platelets to the area. So the whole purpose is, this is your point, is to maintain the integrity of the blood vessel and prevent further blood loss. spillage into other compartments. So usually following injury, there's bleeding. It could be internal, it could be external. Lesions or ulcerations. The purpose of hemostasis is to stop that flow of blood. Another term for hemostasis is coagulation. Next week, we'll talk about agglutination, which is a different term, but they're often confused together. So coagulation is the platelets catching the blood, whereas agglutination is rupturing the blood cells, causing them to stick together. That's next week. Okay, so that's the whole purpose, maintaining the integrity of the blood vessels and preventing further blood loss. It occurs in three phases, 1, 2, 3. We'll talk about each of these on separate slides. You might add details to your notebooks under the 1, 2, 3. So you have vascular spasm. Vascular, anytime you refer to vascular, you're talking about vessels, whether it's a capillary, arterial, artery, venule, vein, any of those, that is referring to vascular. Second step, platelet plug formation. The platelets clump together. And coagulation has to do with the blood, that's your scab, basically, clumping in that platelet area, okay? So each step, 1, 2, 3, the first step is the vascular spasm. This is going to cause the blood vessel to narrow just in the area of the injury. It's not going to be the entire blood vessel. It's going to be localized. So the injury exposes the collagen fibers. We talked about that. They're sticky, platelets stick to the torn fibers. They release two things, serotonin, they release more than two things, but serotonin and thromboxane cause the vascular spasm. So by the vessel constricting, it's further fractioning the platelets. It's breaking them open, rupturing them, so they'll release more chemicals. So remember we talked about positive and negative feedbacks. A positive feedback, the result causes more of the stimulus. So thromboxane, serotonin were your original stimulus. They caused a spasm that caused more thromboxane and serotonin to be released. So it continues the process. Okay, so that causes a vasoconstriction. Vessel constriction, getting smaller. This lasts for about 30 minutes. And another function of this, not just to fraction the platelets, but also because the vessel is smaller, less blood can go through, right? So it's decreasing the blood flow, so you get less blood loss. The second phase is the platelet plug. So platelets stick together and they're gonna plug the hole, okay? The injured cells release chemicals, as you saw in your warm-up. Those chemicals will attract other platelets to the area, as well as cause them to stick to each other. So the stuck platelets release ADP, which attracts more platelets, which cause them to get stuck, which cause them to release more ADP, attracting more platelets, they get stuck. You can see it's a continuing process. So that's a positive feedback. So you're making an initial plug for that hole, basically, using the platelets. So the exposed collagen binds and activates platelets, step one, in this part of the process. This is just phase two, this picture, it's not the whole process, right? So exposed collagen binds and activates. They release platelet fractions, which attract more platelets, which aggregate or clump into the platelet plug. They gather. So I'll give you a moment to write down some words in each of those squares. You have the same picture in your notebook. You can use your own words. You can use these words. You can shorthand. You can initial, as long as it makes sense to you. ECF is referring to extracellular fluid. So all of the tissues in our bodies are bathed with extracellular fluid. Smooth muscles These we're going to find out in the next chapter. This is what controls the size of the blood vessels. So if the smooth muscles contract, the vessel gets smaller. They relax, the vessel gets bigger. This will allow us to adjust our blood pressure. Collagen, that's that sticky protein. Proteins are typically sticky already. So if a blood cell were to fraction and the hemoglobin was exposed, it makes the blood cell itself sticky. Okay, I'm gonna move on. Let me know if you need more time. Shout it out, or Miss Hefty, let me know, because I don't have my chat box open. Okay, so step one was the spasm. Step two was the platelet plug. Step three, now we're gonna make a mesh that will capture the red blood cells. This is the tricky part. So within 30 seconds, after the first two phases have occurred, injured tissue releases thromboplastin. Thromboplastin interacts with the surface of the platelet itself, causing the formation of the enzyme thrombin. So this was part of that flow chart you guys were making. Enzymes, remember, hold things together so they can react. It's gonna hold thrombin with fibrinogen. And then that's going to make long, thin fibrin. So these protein threads right here, this is fibrin. The fibrin makes a mesh. That's going to catch the red blood cells as they go by. So rather than them going out of the hole, it'll catch them in the mesh. This makes what is called a clot, a thrombus.
Miss Snook?
Yes.
Will this slideshow be posted somewhere?
Yes, I think I posted it today.
Okay, thank you.
Mm-hmm. So this is your... flow. So the cells released it, and you guys have this flow chart to fill in. The cells release the thromboplastin. This binds with your platelets. What they're binding with on the platelet is thrombin. That's an enzyme. Combines it with fibrinogen. When these come together, they make fibrin, those yellow threads. They might not actually be yellow. They are in this particular picture. Okay, the blue things in this picture are your platelets. The red things are your red blood cells, erythrocytes. Giving you a minute to fill in this flow chart. And yes, you can always come back afterwards and fill in the blanks if you missed them. I'll pretend I'm typing. So shout out or let Miss Hefty know if you need more time. I'm about to go to the next slide. You are not going to need to know all these details, but I wanted to show you that this process is really a lot more complicated than what we're making it. So there's lots of these numbers. So you read about factor 8. These numbers, these are all factors that are involved in this overall process. And any of our blood, our bleeding disorders, have to do with often one of these enzymes or factors not being in a sufficient amount. The most common factor to be lacking for hemophilia, for example, is factor 8. So you notice all of these things have to happen before we ever get to thrombin, which is preceded by prothrombin. So I'm going to show you this video just to show you how all of this works.
At the site of vessel injury, the first platelets arrive to start sealing the wound. Simultaneously, the coagulation cascade with its various coagulation factors is activated. This involves two pathways, the extrinsic and the intrinsic pathway. Extrinsic activation begins with now exposed molecules of the vessel wall, such as tissue factor, which forms a complex with factor 7. Finally leading to the activation of factor 10. This factor 10A is the point at which the extrinsic and the intrinsic pathways of the coagulation cascade meet. The intrinsic pathway consists of various coagulation factors activating each other in a chain reaction. At its end, a complex with an additional cofactor is formed. This complex now activates factor 10. Since the two pathways merge at the level of factor 10A, this factor has a pivotal role in the coagulation cascade. Further down the cascade, factor 10A, in combination with 5A, activates thrombin and induces the so-called thrombin burst. One molecule of factor 10A can catalyze the formation of 1,000 molecules of thrombin. These large amounts of thrombin cause the further activation of platelets and the enhanced formation of fibrin. Fibrin then forms strands, making up the mesh that stabilizes the platelet plug in an arterial clot and holds together the red blood cells in a venous clot. It can be concluded that the central role of factor 10A in the coagulation cascade makes it a viable...
Okay. We don't have to know all those factors, obviously. When you go to college and you take some advanced classes, you will learn all of those phases. But mostly what I like in that video is how it shows you how the thrombin is changed into a fibrous form. So that's what I like about it. So in the end, we're going to retract the serum, which is blood plasma minus all of the cellular components and the protein components. So it's just the liquid part of the blood. So our body like sucks it back in. And you can imagine if you have a cut, it's like vacuum sealing it. It's pulling the edges together when you retract that fluid. So that makes a tight seal. That's what's creating that scar you're going to have. So we pull that back within an hour. All right. Then, you know, you wash your wound and you cover it with an antibiotic ointment, and then you're going to put gauze on it. So gauze serves a couple purposes. One, obviously, to hold the blood in place so you don't make a mess. But for the natural purpose, what it's doing is it's giving a rough surface for the platelets to adhere. So this is taking the place of fibrin before your body forms it. Pressure, because you're always told to put pressure on that injury, right? So you put the gauze on there for the platelets to adhere, and then you add pressure, which is like the vascular spasm. It's fracturing those cells so that they'll release their chemicals and speed up the whole healing process. So you wanna leave your Band-Aid, your gauze in place. I know I like to like, especially if it's a really bad cut, I like to show everybody, you know, and I keep taking it off and showing people. But every time you do that, you're ripping off those chemicals that have begun to release and the platelets that have begun to seal. So you don't want to do that. So that's the purpose of the gauze and the pressure. They're actually acting, they're playing a role that your body plays naturally, just speeding it up. So we were creating a thrombus, right? A clot. That's a good thing. We want to break those holes or We want to plug those holes. What we don't want is for that clot to be released into the bloodstream. Then it travels through the bloodstream and it blocks very narrow passageways like capillaries. You might have heard of pulmonary embolisms. So this is something we try to prevent after surgeries in particular. They'll give you blood thinners. They'll put circulating socks on you. They'll use like this massaging machine to keep your blood flowing. Because like your body is releasing those proteins in the platelets in order to clot whatever needs clotting from your surgery. But it is not uncommon for those platelet plugs to break off and then travel through the bloodstream. And people have died simply from knee surgeries, from an embolism that has broken loose and gotten into blood vessels. One of our teacher's wife died that way. So it's not terribly uncommon. So doctors know to try to prevent it. All right. So this is a word that came up in the warm-up. Thrombocytopenia is simply the insufficient number of platelets. Okay. So platelets, thrombocyte cells. Any word that ends in penia, any of our cells, you can have a specific like you'd probably have basophilia. The ending tells you there's not enough. Philia means attracted to. So hemophilia is blood attracted to blood, which you would think makes a clot, but it really means like it's attracted to the flow. So that's a little tricky. So insufficient thrombocytes could arise if you have a bone marrow cancer. Radiation, different drugs can cause this. If you think of where the blood plate or the hemocytoblasts are, right, they're in the bone marrow. So if we're radiating or we're creating cancer in the bone marrow, you can see how that would interfere with formation of different cells. Hemophilia, lacking different clotting factors, usually factor 8. It's hereditary. It's sex-linked recessive, actually. So it's passed through the mom's side, typically. So this is a little baby, had a little cut, and you can see the blood flow. It just keeps going. It usually, like, gets trapped in joints, but even a minor injury can be life-threatening. Khan Academy, if you want some help, you can go back and look at that. Are there any slides you would like me to revisit? So hemostasis, I've simplified your cascade, right? We just need to know the thrombin on. Thromboplastin, fibrinogen, fibrin. Okay, we want to know the three steps. The vascular spasm, platelet plug, and the coagulation. And basic description of each will be enough. Okay. Going back to our agenda, I'm going to let you guys do this on your own.